Dear students, good morning to all of you. Now I am going to talk on Amartya Kumar Sen. Amartya Sen was born in a Hindu family in Bengal, British India. Amartya Sen's family was from Wari and Manikganj, Dhaka, both in present day Bangladesh. His father, Ashutosh Sen, was professor of chemistry at Dhaka University, development commissioner in Delhi, and then chairman of the West Bengal Public Service Commission. He moved with his family to West Bengal in 1945. Amartya Sen was born on November 3, 1933 at Chandni Keten, India. He is an Indian economist who was awarded the Nobel Prize in Economic Science for his contributions. When Amartya Sen was nominated for the Nobel Prize officially, he made a call to his mother and shared his happiness. Mother was happy and says, "My husband, when he died in 1971, there was already talk of Bapu's chance of winning the Nobel. On his deathbed, Ashutosh Sen had regretted not being able to survive long enough to see their son win the Nobel Prize." Amartya Sen's father, when he was in his deathbed, he regrets that he was not able to see his son's getting Nobel Prize. Amartya Sen was named by the first Indian Nobel laureate, Rabindranath Tagore, with whom the Sen had a close relation. The name Amartya, it was given by Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore. In Sanskrit, Amartya means immortal. In Sanskrit, Amartya means immortal. There is no end for him. Amartya did his formal education at Saint George's School, Dhaka, now in Bangladesh. After he moved to Shantiniketan, he studied at Tagore School. Even at a very young age, he wanted to become a teacher and research, and his thought stayed with him in his growing years also. Amartya Sen tried subjects like Sanskrit, mathematics, and physics in his young age, but he attracted towards economics in his own words as the eccentric charms of economics. When he was young, he tried subjects like Sanskrit, mathematics, and physics, but he attracted towards economics. He loved that subject, economics. Some attraction towards that subject, economics. He was deeply influenced by the cultural diversity in the world as part of his curriculum in Shantiniketan. He studied cultural, analytical, and scientific heritage of India. He also studied other non-Western cultures such as East and South, East Asia including China, Japan, Indonesia, Korea, West Asia, and Africa. He studied varied cultural heritage of India. Not only India, he studied other countries also, other countries' culture also, such as East and South, East Asia, including China, Japan, Indonesia, Korea, West Asia, and Africa. In 1940, Amartya experienced the shift from a United Indian People to a sectarian. Sectarian means a large religion group, society of Hindu, Muslim or Sikh community. There was a man named Kadarmia. A poor man came to Amartya's house, bleeding abundantly one afternoon. After this incident, Amartya Sen felt very bad. One afternoon, Kadarmia came to his house. He had come for some work in the neighboring house of Amartya. He was stabbed badly on the street by the communal gangsters. And to escape from them, he entered into the house of Amartya. He wanted to escape from communal gangsters, so he entered into Amartya's house. Already that communal gangster stabbed him. So he was bleeding. Kadarmia was bleeding. After seeing that, Amartya's father took him to a hospital. On the way, Kadarmia kept saying that his wife had told not to go to enemy's area. But he had to come to his enemy's area for searching work as his family had nothing to eat. Poverty. They did not have anything to eat, so that he had to go to his enemy's area for searching job. He died in the hospital due to his economic condition. This incident, along with his personal experiences at Dhaka, was the basis of his research in economics for his in his later days. This made him to study on economics. He did a research on economics in later days. It also alerted him to a fact that the economic limitation in the form of poverty could make a person helpless prey in the society. Then he joined at Presidency College during the period 1951 to 53 at Calcutta, where he formed a fair attitude on cultural identity. Education at Calcutta broadened his intellect. He acquired knowledge. He was greatly influenced by three teachers. They are Babu Tostata, Tapusa Majumdar. Third teacher is Dinesh Bhattacharya. The student community of the Presidency College was politically active. Though he did not have any enthusiasm to join any political party, he had the quality of sympathy and egalitarian commitment. Egalitarian means social equality. This led him to involve himself in running evening schools for illiterate rural children in the neighboring villages. He did not have any interest in politics. Then too, he had sympathy at people. Always he wanted social equality, egalitarian sympathy, social equality. He fought for social equality. This led him to involve himself in running evening schools for illiterate people, illiterate rural children in the neighboring villages. He was very kind. Amartya Sen was deeply disturbed by the Bengal famine of 1943, in which 2 or 3 million people had died, was still fresh in his memory. This Bengal famine disturbed him a lot. It happened in the year 1943, but after so many years also, he remembered that incident. He remembered that Bengal famine. None of his friends or relatives was affected. Only landless rural laborers were affected. He considered this as a class-dependent character of famine. He was in dilemma and felt the traditional values of tolerance of plurality were at stake. Here also partial is there. Here also class difference there. Upper class and lower class. Laborer only suffer, not other people. Other people, they were very happy. Laborer only suffered. It upset Amartya Sen a lot. In 1953, he joined Trinity College at Cambridge. Though he had already obtained a BA Economics from Calcutta University, again he enrolled BA Pure Economics at Cambridge. He did his PhD under the supervision of A.K. Dasgupta of Banaras University, an economist, methodologist, India. When Amartya was 23 years old, he was given a chance to set up the Department of Economics at Jadavpur University. Many people criticized him, just snatched from the cradle. They made fun at him. But he proved his intellectual identity in the university. Amartya Sen submitted his PhD thesis for a competitive prize fellowship at Trinity College. He got selected and went to Cambridge, where he spent years and studied philosophy on his own interest. In 1963, he decided to leave Cambridge and went to Delhi School of Economics, where he taught till 1971, along with an eminent economist K.N. Roy, as the head of the Delhi School, started the school a preeminent center of education in economics and social science in India. He fell himself into the social choice theory. Then he shifted himself from the theory of social choice to practical problems. Later on, he believed in practical problems. What are problems there? He wants to solve that problem practically. After Amartya went to London, he had serious health problems. At the age of 18, he had developed cancer in the mouth. He was treated with radiation. Cancer was cured, but the radiation killed the bones in his odd palate. Anyhow, he recovered from the surgery after undergoing a long operation of nearly 7 hours. Gradually, Amartya shifted his interest from the pure theory of social choice to more practical problems. He shifted his interest to practical problems. He fought for gender equality, men's relative advantage. He fought for women, especially women's rights, poverty, unemployment, violence. The results were published in journals in 2 collections of articles, Choice, Welfare, Measurement and Resources and Values and Development published respectively in 1982 and 1984. Amartya shifted to America in 1985. He published a book named Inequality Re-examined in 1992, in which he analyzed the implications of the perspective on welfare economics and political philosophy. Sen was very much attached to his motherland, and he never stayed away from his homeland for more than 6 months. When he was awarded the money for his kind nature, he offered the money to his Pratichi Trust, which was doing charity work in India and Bangladesh. The charity work was his passion. He had, since the days he had started running evening schools in surrounding villages 50 years ago, already he started his charity work when he was in his young age. He started teaching illiterate children in the neighboring villages. It happened 50 years ago. Now he expanded his charity work. As Amartya Sen says, it's really economics dealing with the assessment of how well things are going for the members of the society. This is the central thing about welfare economics. According to Royal Swedish Academy of Science, Sen combined tools from economics and philosophy and restored an ethical dimension for vital economic problems. Amartya Sen published more than 20 books to his credit and had received many awards. He received the Indira Gandhi Gold Medal Award of the Asiatic Society 1994, Nobel Prize for Economics 1998, Eisenhower Medal USA in 2000, and Honorary Companion of Honor UK in 2000. He is known as the Mother Teresa of economics, as he championed the cause of poverty. He continued his academic teaching work as a master at Trinity College, Cambridge, UK. He made his ideas global. I hope you all understand this lesson. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in WhatsApp chat box. Thank you. I just end up the session. Thank you, girls.